In Penkenna Manor, a newborn baby's cry was heard for the first time. As the Baron cradled his daughter, his Princess Isabella, she fell silent, smiled up at him, her bright blue eyes sparkled like her mother's. In that instant, death's shadow fell upon his wife, and within the hour, Baroness Isabel Penkenna, his childhood sweetheart, died. The Baron's world fell apart. He hugged his daughter, swore an oath to shield her from the world's cruelness. Would ensure she received the finest education, guidance, and training, to prepare her for the future position as Baroness Penkenna, the true provider and protector of the people and all lands appertaining to the manor. As the years passed, wrecking became the greatest threat to lives and the economy of the Cornish coastline. The Baron, a strong, just man, made a stand, establishing a force of special soldiers, trained in offshore combat. But in the year 1843, the cruel, merciless wrecker, Scorpion, targeted Crackington and Penkenna Manor, on a mission to overpower the Baron's forces and secure the greatest prize ever. The Baron's daughter, Bella, as she preferred to be called, had matured into a fine woman. Inheriting her mother's charm and beauty, her father's grit, she radiated elegance and a natural deportment of nobility. Bella was a gifted sailor and proficient swordswoman, a sassy independent firebrand, out to make a name for herself in the world. The responsibilities and duties of the manor, she despised, shunned, causing a rift with the Baron that broke his heart. Undeterred, he produced many suitors for Bella, insisting they brought calmness and responsibility to a marriage. Bella laughed, rejected them all, and became increasingly frustrated at being tied to the apron strings of the manor. One bright morning, while walking on Crackington Beach, Bella stumbled, literally, into Captain James Fitzgerald, a dashing shipping owner, a beacon of hope, who romanced her, persuaded her, to go sail the world with him. Bella dizzily agreed, defying the Baron's disapproval of the stranger. The exhilarating dream of eloping soon became reality. As the midnight hour drew near, Bella's heart raced. Finally, she was free of the manor, to start the greatest adventure of her life. But then, an image of her father filled her thoughts. She had said he was overbearing. But was he, really? Or was she being unfair? In hindsight, Bella realized her safety and best interests were her father's only wish. Realized the Baron needed and loved her so much. Mrs. Guilt fought Mrs. Selfish. It was a hard battle. To the victor, the spoils. Outside, a violent storm erupted, battering the coast. The alarm sounded. Scorpion was in Crackington Bay, had set lights on the rocks, and two merchant ships had run aground. Hulls smashed, sailors and cargo cast into the savage waves. Many of her father's guards were killed in the attack, including Bella's closest friend and supportive rock, Adrian. Scorpion had fought him, run him through, left him to die. Secretly, Adrian had loved Bella, though words were never spoken, emotions never tested. Adrian's death struck a vengeful chord in her heart. Bella vowed to bring the evil wrecker to justice, if it was the last thing she did. News came that Scorpion had been captured and taken to the Baron, who unfortunately had been hurt in the battle. A shoulder injury that was being treated by the doctor. Bella ran to her father's side. Seeing a man in chains, she reached for her sword, but recoiled. "Wait, there must be some mistake. This man is Captain James Fitzgerald," she pleaded mercy. It was revealed that Scorpion and James Fitzgerald were one and the same man, united as one soul, yet, divided in equal measure. Bella wept, not just for herself, but realized how her father must have felt when he lost her mother. Pain tore into her heart. Love tried to soothe it, but instead was slashed to pieces. The Baron had Scorpion cast into the manor dungeons. He was to hang for his crimes. Bella had to take action. Her father was recovering well. He would understand. She first met the captain of the guard, then rushed to the dungeons and used the keys to unlock the cell door. Grabbing James's hand, they ran free to a rowing boat tied up in the bay. The storm was horrendous. They halted, and eventually reached the wrecker's ship. The crew were waiting to flee. Scorpion held Bella close. "Come, my love, freedom and adventure calls, we can live our dream." Bella pulled away. "I cannot go with you. I hate you, Scorpion, but I cannot see you die, for you will take my beloved James with you, and I love him so." Bella and James Fitzgerald kissed one last time. As Scorpion climbed the rope ladder to the deck, Bella rowed back into the bay. The Baron, alerted to Scorpion's aided escape, was helped to the beach, trying to make sense of the unfolding nightmare of it all. He saw the wrecker's ship sail, Bella's rowing boat crash and splinter on the rocks. As Bella screamed, the Baron fell to his knees. Two guards swam out to rescue Bella, but the waves were too powerful. One guard was smashed on the rocks, pulled beneath the choking water. The second staggered from the sea and handed the Baron a piece of Bella's blood-soaked dress. He clutched the cloth to his chest, Bella's warm life blood saturated his shirt. It was then he knew. Bella was gone forever. A blue mist rose from the sea and blanketed the bay and cliffs. As it dispersed, the Baron saw a face carved into the rock. His Princess Isabella. As the Baron's tears mingled with the rain upon his face, he heard Bella's voice carried upon the storm. "Forgive me, Father. I have been foolish. I should not have defied you, but I could not let James, my true love, die. For my penance, I shall remain here in spirit to watch over the bay. I will love you, my Father, always and forever." From that moment, whenever a storm erupts in Crackington Haven, Isabella's face can be seen within the craggy cliff face, overlooking the bay, watching, protecting sailors and ships, her sweet voice emitting a powerful mantra. "I am Princess Isabella Pinkenna, and I will not allow wrecking in my bay." Thank you.